Good afternoon. Welcome to Brazel Stadium. Michael Potter here with you for Game 3 between the Lopes and the Bears of Northern Colorado. Just about set for the first pitch here. The Lopes took the first two in this series, trying for the sweep here. And the first pitch up high and away to Dean Lawson, the leadoff batter for the Bears. And we are underway here in Game 3. The Lopes come in 11-14, 5-0 in conference play. The Bears 11-14 and 3-2 in conference play. 1-1 count to Dean Lawson on the mound for GCU. The 6-foot freshman out of Gilbert, Arizona, and Basha High, Jack Schneider, getting his third career start, got his first win in his last start a week ago against Bakersfield. Fouled off again, so Schneider 1-2, and Jack Schneider a 3.38 ERA, that record of 1-0. This is, of course, his third start, his fourth appearance in 10 2/3. He's given up 7 hits, 4 runs. They were all earned. He's walked 5 and struck out 5. Opponents hitting 200 against Schneider. We'll get to set on the defense after this pitch. The 1-2. Fouled off again. Count remains. Josh Meyer behind the plate once again doing the catching. His third consecutive start in this series. Tyler Wyatt in left. Tom LaRouge in center. Garrison Schwartz in right. Zach Malis at third. Mark Mumper at short. Austin Bull at second. Ian Evans at first base. Only change in the lineup today. Quinn Cotton is not playing, and Greg Sines is the DH. The 1-2 up high, 2-2. Well, for the Bears, no changes except for a flip between the 7 and 8 hole hitter. Dean Lawson, the second baseman, leads off. Evan Johnson, the left fielder, bats second. Cole Maltese, the DH, bats third. Jack Pauley, the right fielder, bats fourth. Full count, 3-2. Brett Minnick, the first baseman, bats fifth. Nick Tanner in center field bats sixth. Matt Burkhart, the freshman third baseman, bats seventh. Alex Keel, the junior catcher, bats eighth. And Tyler Yamaguchi, the shortstop, bats ninth. 3-2 count to Dean Lawson, leading off the ball game. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. So Lawson goes down swinging to open the ball game for the third time in a row in this series. He was a strikeout victim of Jake Wong on Friday night, a strikeout victim of Jake Repovich on Saturday afternoon, and a strikeout victim of Jack Schneider here on Sunday. So one down. That'll bring up Evan Johnson. Strike on the outside corner. Johnson didn't like it. Behind in the count here. Well, the Lopes got the victory 7-0 behind a great pitching performance by Jake Wong on Friday night. He went 7 1/3, gave up just 2 hits and no runs, walked 1 and struck out 5. Swing and a miss. 0-2. Followed up on a Saturday performance by Jake Repovich, went 7 innings strong, 6 hits, 3 runs, 2 were earned, walked no one and struck out 5. Benavides and Hart came in to finish it off, and it was a 12-3 victory for the Lopes. Fouled off. Johnson still looking for his first base hit in this series. The top of the order, the top three for the Bears, Lawson, Johnson, and Maltese, a combined 1-for-24 with no runs, no ribbies, and 8 strikeouts. Breaking pitch, waited on it, lifts it into shallow right. No problem for the right fielder, Garrison Schwartz. 2 up, 2 down. Well, based on those numbers I gave you of Lawson, Johnson, and Maltese, as you can imagine, Friday and Saturday, 1-2-3 innings for the Lopes pitchers, and Schneider trying to do the same here on a Sunday. Cole Maltese, the redshirt junior, right-handed hitting DH. He played right field on Friday, but was the DH on Saturday. First pitch misses. Ball one. Umpires for the action this afternoon, Gary Gilman behind home plate, Steve Mattingly at first, and Carl Coles at third. Up high. 2-0. And a 3-0 count to Cole Maltese. Maltese in this series, 0-for-8 with 3 strikeouts. That one missed, so a 4-pitch walk. Schneider cannot do as his predecessors did and get a 1-2-3 inning to get the ball game going. So Maltese aboard with the walk. First time Cole Maltese has been on base in this series. GCU and New Mexico State, the only two teams undefeated in conference play. The chopper by Pauly. Evans has it. Flip, covering, and the out. Well, Ian Evans, we see him range over to the right a long way. That time, able to get it in the underhand toss. He's talking to Jack Schneider right now, but that is the inning on the 3-1 putout. No runs, no hits, no errors. One man left on base. So Schneider pitches around the two-out walk. No score as we go to the bottom of the first. Lopes coming up. Well, you can get the best gear to show off your Lope pride. Just go to lopeshops.gcu.edu to find everything GCU, from the newest apparel to the coolest accessories. Use promo code GCUTV20. You can get 20% off for being a GCU TV viewer. Let's paint the valley purple. Lopes up. Well, the Lopes don't get a 1-2-3 inning, but a 1-2-4 inning, I guess you'd say. And in the dugout, ready to go to work here. GCU has won the first two, and they'll send up Austin Bull to lead things off. Tom LaRouge will bat second. Ian Evans bats third. Garrison Schwartz, the cleanup man. Tyler Wyatt in left field bats fifth. Zach Malice bats sixth. Greg Sines, the DH today, bats seventh. Josh Meyer, the catcher, bats eighth. And Mark Mumper bats ninth. So Bull, LaRouge, Evans, Garrison Schwartz, Tyler Wyatt, Zach Malice, and then Sines, Meyer, and Mumper to conclude the batting lineup. On the mound for the Bears, number 37, Connor Liedholm, the redshirt junior left-hander. Look at Liedholm's numbers, 4.50 ERA. This is his second start and eighth appearance. In 18 innings, 19 hits, 9 runs, they were all earned. He walked 4 and struck out 13. Opponents hitting 271 against Connor Liedholm. Liedholm will throw to Alex Keel behind home plate, left to right in the outfield. Evan Johnson, Nick Tanner, Jack Pauly, Matt Burkhardt at third, Tyler Yamaguchi at short, Dean Lawson at second, Brett Minnick at first. Connor Liedholm not named the starter till late after the game yesterday. So Bull will lead things off. Stark differences between the top three in the order for the Bears is Bull takes a strike one, and the top two for GCU. Bull hitting .396 on the year, no homers, but 9 RBI. He's walked 18 times and fouled off. Got an on-base percentage of .487, so getting aboard nearly half of the time. Bull and LaRouge, the top two table setters in the lineup, have really been doing everything. The 0-2, up high, 1-2. Combined 8 for 15, hitting .533 in the two games of this series. 5 runs, 5 ribbies, 5 walks, and they're 3 for 3 in stolen bases. One's fouled off out of play. So the Lopes really getting support from everyone throughout the lineup here in this series. But those top two have just been devastating for the Bears. Inside, 2-2. Austin Bull in his sophomore campaign. He's a guy that the Lopes have high hopes for. They played him at short early on this season, trying to fill in for the vacated position that Pauly Panichon left when he went to the Nationals. 3-2, full count. Last few games, they've had Mark Mumper starting at short. Move Bull over to his probably more normal position at second base. Foul back again. So Bull having a good at-bat. Talked to the skipper, Andy Stankiewicz, prior to the ball game, and of course we put that up on SoundCloud. And if you just follow us on Twitter at GCU _Lopes or at GCU Baseball, we'll tweet out that interview and you can hear the coach's thoughts a couple hours before the game. 3-2 pitch. Ooh, what a take. Man, that was close on the inside corner. Ball 4. That is the 6th walk from the top two. And once again, leadoff man is aboard. Well, Bull struck out last game and flew out in the first game, his first time up. So, first time he has reached base in the first inning. That'll bring up Tom LaRouge. LaRouge hitting .345, 1 homer, 9 RBI. Squaring to bunt. Pitch misses down low, ball one. Well, LaRouge, another guy who had fantastic freshman sophomore year. High hopes for him, but he had that injury last year, so they've had to slowly get him in the lineup. Nice bunt. It's going to be a tough play even to get him at first. They're not going to get him. Boy, it took Burkhart forever to get down there to get that ball and not going to get LaRouge. What a pretty bunt that was. And so now the first two are aboard, and Ian Evans, your number three-hole hitter. You typically don't take the bat out of the number three-hole hitter's hands, but Evans has been struggling a bit, so we'll see if Coach Stankiewicz wants to put a couple runners in scoring position for the heart of the lineup. Beautiful day for baseball here at Brazos. We've had good weather, a little chilly on Friday night, but chilly for us here in Phoenix, but not for anywhere else in the country. First pitch, Evans not showing bunt, outside ball one. We did see in the ball game yesterday, Josh Meyer came up with runners at first and second in a pretty obvious bunt situation, but Coach Stankiewicz gave him one swing of his own, and he went for the downs but came up empty, and then he did the sack bunt, or tried the sack bunt on the next pitch. The 1-0 to Evans, checking Bull out at second. Through the right side, that's going to get through. They're going to try to score Austin Bull. He's on his horse. The throw is going to be cut off. Nope, it goes past the cutoff man, but LaRouge takes third either way, and it's an RBI single for Ian Evans. The Lopes draw first blood, and it's 1-0 GCU. Well, good speed on the base pass and good base running by the base runners there. LaRouge taking third and still nobody out. And Garrison Schwartz at the plate. Evans picks up his 19th RBI of the season. Lopes picking up right where they left off the last couple of games. Scored 19 runs in the first two games. Now they're their 20th run of the series. Pitch in there for strike one. Schwartz off to a slow start this season, hitting 235, two homers, 16 RBI, still second on the team. Runs batted in. Pitch missed on the outside corner, 1-1. So Evans, just his second hit of the series, but his fifth RBI, so he has been productive. In the air, hit pretty well, slicing away from the center fielder, but Tanner tracks it down. Makes the grab. LaRouge scores easily on the sack fly to center. 2-0 GCU. So the first out of the inning comes on the sack fly. Wyatt at the plate with just one out. And Evans still down there at first. Well, the hearty order, get guys in scoring position. Coach Stankiewicz in the pregame interview today said you just want those guys to be aggressive. Drive runs in, throw over an Evans back, and that's what so far they have done. 17th RBI of the season for Garrison Schwartz. Wyatt hitting 327, one homer, six RBI. Wyatt having another good series here. Swing and a miss. Wyatt hitting 500 in the series. 3-for-6 with 3 runs, 2 RBI, and he's walked 4 times. Coming off that great series against Bakersfield, low and away. In the first WAC series, when the Lopes swept Bakersfield, Wyatt hit 600, 6-for-10 with 4 runs, 1 ribby, and 1 walk. Throw over an Evans back. Evans 2-for-2 in stolen base attempts this year. 2-0 GCU, still in the bottom of the first, just one out and a man on first. Pitch to Wyatt, fouled off right side. Count goes to 1-2. Well, just underway in Seattle, New Mexico State looking for the sweep, and they're up 4-0 in the top of the second. Seattle's got some issues they got to get fixed up there. The team picked to win the WAC. Only has one conference win. And they're staring at a 1-5 if they get swept by New Mexico State. The team picked to finish second. 2-2 to Wyatt. Ground ball to short. Could be two. Yamaguchi to Lawson. Back to first. The stretch kept his foot on the bag, and that is the inning. So Wyatt grounds into the 6-4-3 inning-ending double play. And we will head it to a break here. But the Lopes up 2-0 as GCU in that inning gets two runs on two hits. There were no errors and nobody left on base. We have completed one, 2-0 GCU. This is Lopes Baseball on GCU TV.
Learn the art of hospitality management at GCU, right in the heart of Phoenix, Arizona, a top tourism market bustling with opportunity for our hospitality students. Join the student team at GCU Hotel, delivering unmatched service plus amenities like the Oasis Pool, Fitness Center, and Canyon 49 Grill. Learn golf management at GCU Championship Golf Course, featuring over 7,200 yards of expansive tees and tree-lined fairways. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu.
So Jack Schneider back on the hill has got a 2-0 lead as the Lopes get a leadoff walk, a bunt single, and then an RBI single by Evans and a sack fly by Garrison Schwartz as they try to sweep this series and go to a perfect 6-0 in conference play. Schneider will face 5-6-7, his only hiccup in the first inning, a walk to Cole Maltese, the number 3-hole hitter with two outs, but then he got Pauly to ground out a little chopper to first base. So Minnick, Tanner, and Burkhart due up for the Bears. Bears came in a hot-hitting squad, and boy, they have been silenced here by these Lopes pitchers. Minnick in 286 on the season. First pitch, strike on the outside corner. Lopes thought they had their rotation set to start the season as that one misses outside. It was really going to be Jake Wong and Deegan Hart flipping the Friday and Saturday role and Repovich on a Sunday, but Hart scuffled a bit early and they easily made the decision to move Wong as that one's ripped into left. Wyatt coming in, makes the grab. Hit well, but the line out is the first out of the inning, and that'll bring up Nick Tanner. Tanner, 234 on the year, one homer, 10 RBI. In this series, Tanner hit 2-for-7, hitting 286 with no homers and one ribby. So lefty-lefty matchup here. Fouls it off. That one's going to get out of play. To finish that thought, Deegan Hart, a 9.11 ERA, 0-5, and he has been relegated to the bullpen, so you had the two Jakes, Wong and Rep, going Friday and Saturday. Weren't sure who was going to take over the Sunday role. Up high, 1-1. Snyder pitched pretty well out of the pen at UNLV on the 14th of March. Gave him a start at New Mexico. That went in the air to left center field. Coming in is LaRouge, but that's going to fall in front of him. Plays it off a bounce, and first base hit of the ball game for the Bears. So Tanner aboard, this third hit of the series. Matt Burkhart at the plate. So Burkhart hitting 231 on the year. No homers, two RBI. The start in New Mexico went 4 1/3 and just gave up one run. Walked a couple of guys, but held that powerful offense in check in his first career start. Fouled off. That got Schneider another start against Bakersfield. He went 5 innings to pick up his first collegiate win. Touched him for a couple runs in the first, but his last 4 innings of work were scoreless before he handed it over to the bullpen and led to the Lopes' victory and the sweep of that series. The 0-1 to Burkhart. Swings through a breaking pitch, 0-2. And a little good news, too, we saw Deegan Hart come in and close out the ball game on Saturday night, last night, through an inning and struck out two. So maybe Deegan's found a home coming out of the pen, up high, 1-2. But as of now, you would imagine, and Coach Tankwood seems to be very, very comfortable with Friday, Saturday, and getting more and more comfortable with Jack Schneider as he sees more of this freshman lefty from Gilbert, Arizona. Throw over and the runner back. That win against Bakersfield in just his third appearance, Schneider became the quickest GCU pitcher to earn a win since Repovich earned the win in his second career appearance back in 2015 against UNLV. The 1-2 up high, 2-2. Starting pitching has been doing the trick for GCU. In the air, fouled off. Meyer coming back, going to run out of room, and that one's going to not get into the stands because it's going to hit on that little sunshade up there and roll somewhere. Did it stay up there? I mean, if something goes up, it's got to come down eventually, right? Must have stuck up there on the sunshade. 2-2 the count remains. One out here in the second. The lopes up 2-0. Pitch from Schneider. Line drive. Going to get past Bull. The runner, Tanner, had to hold to make sure Bull couldn't snag it. And then he hustles into second. So back-to-back base hits by Tanner and Burkhart. And you got runners at first and second with just one out. That'll bring up Alex Keel. Keel on the season hitting .239. No homers and four RBI. In this series, still looking for his first base hit, 0 for 6. Too big of a lead out there at second. Schneider chases him back. Well, the two Jakes combined 6-3 on the year, and their two starts here Friday and Saturday, they went 14 1/3, gave up 8 hits, 3 runs, 2 earned, struck out 10, a combined 1.26 ERA. You know, win a lot of ball games when you can start those guys out Friday and Saturday. 0-1 the count to Keel. Schneider trying to follow suit here. In the air, shallow center, Mumper going out, LaRouge coming in. Mumper is going to call everybody off and make the grab. Nice catch. LaRouge maybe could have got there, but not confident enough to call him off. And Mumper ranging into shallow center to make the grab. That'll bring up the shortstop, Tyler Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi hitting .228, 2 homers, 9 RBI. Had the solo homer back in the third inning in the ballgame yesterday. After that solo homer, Jake Repovich retired 13 in a row. And almost closing out the game in the seventh for the 10-run rule, gave up back-to-back doubles and an error led to a couple runs coming across, and Lopes had to play into the ninth. First pitch in there for strike one. Well, that play by Mumper ranging out there, looking up in the sun, making the grab. Not an easy play, and Mark makes a lot of plays look pretty easy out there at shortstop. Talking to the starting pitchers, Jake Wong and Jake Repovich, and they really like that infield with Mumper at short and Bull at second. Very confident up the middle. Into center. LaRouge makes the grab, and that is the inning. Nicely done by the freshman lefty as Jack Schneider works around the back-to-back base hit single. So no runs on two hits. There were no errors and a couple left on base. We go to the bottom of the second, 2-0 GCU. Well, if you're on Lidl back on the hill, down 2-0 as he gave up a couple of runs in the first inning to GCU. He'll face Malice, Sines, Meyer, and Mumper. 6, 7, 8, and 9 due up for GCU. The one thing that Grand Canyon has been able to do throughout this series, after they hang a crooked number on the board, they continue to put up 1 and 2 here and there to apply the pressure. On Friday, they got 3 in the 4th and then added 1 in the 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th to win it 7-0. And on Saturday, they got 3 in the 2nd and then scored 3 more in the 4th and 6 in the 6th to win it 12-3. So not content with just 2 here. See if they can put a couple more on the board here in the 2nd. Zach Malice hitting 241 on the year, no homers and 12 RBI. Zach named an at-large bid to the 2017 preseason All-WAC team. Take strike one. Malice 3 for 10 in this series, 1-1. Scored a couple runs, has an RBI. Struck out a couple times as well. Chop foul. Here goes a 1-ball, 2-strikes. Malice, a good athlete, played shortstop in high school. Played first base the majority of the time last year for GCU in his freshman campaign. That one ripped into right field for a base hit. Jammed him, able to fight it off and pull it into right field. So Malice picks up the base knock and leadoff man aboard for the second inning in a row. They'll bring up Greg Sines. You know, when the Lopes played in Greeley last year, we saw Malice move over to third a couple times to get the man at the plate. Now Greg Sines into the lineup. He looked really good over there, but they put him back at first for the rest of the year. Played a little third in the summer, and then Lopes liked that move, so they've got him at third base this year. Especially helpful that Ian Evans coming in, locked down that first base role. Greg Sines, 286, 2 homers, 4 RBI. Bunting, going to bunt it foul, 1-1. Sines did not play in this series. So Sines getting in there, and it has been tough for him. He had to displace Quinn Cotton. And Quinn's been playing well in this series. Had been the DH, hitting 667, 4 for 6. Way outside. Keel has to block it. 2 runs for Cotton, 2 ribby, a walk, a hit by pitch. So the freshman really earned a chance to play here today, but Coach Dinkowitz wanting to get Sines in the lineup, put him into the DH. Only change in the lineup today. Throw over. Runner dives back. Malice 2 for 4 on stolen base attempts. Has 1 stolen base in the series. There he goes. Looks like a bit of a hit and run as Sines reaches out and taps it foul. So Zach will go back there. 2-2 count. Malice stole the bag in the 6th inning of the ballgame last night. Eventually came around to score the 8th run of the ballgame. Had a pretty good jump on that one. But he was looking back the whole way, and Greg was reaching out to make contact. Two-two pitch. Malice going again. Chopper to third. Burkhart's got it. Fires to first for the first out of the inning, and Malice takes second. Might have been a stolen base. Got a good jump on that one, but Sides with 2 strikes. Had to try to put the ball in play. Malice now at second base in scoring position. Josh Meyer at the plate. Josh Meyer in 258 on the year, no homer, 7 RBI. Thought we might see a different catcher in there, but Meyer's been playing well, hitting the .125 in the series, though. Does have a couple of RBI. As I mentioned, this bottom third of the order for GCU has 7 ribby. He's going to get number eight here. Breaking pitch on the outside corner for a strike. The 0-1. Missed outside 1-1. Well, three catchers on this squad, and Barnes, the most starts with 12. This is the 10th start of the season for Meyer. And then Jared McDonald, seemingly the guy on the outside looking in, just four starts. Chop to third. Burkhart, long throw across. Gets his man, two outs. I'm bringing up Mark Mumper. Mumper, .163 on the year, one homer, eight RBI, had the three-run homer in the ball game yesterday in the bottom of the second inning to put the Lopes aboard. And his only other homer in his GCU career was against the Bears up in Greeley, a three-run homer. So couldn't get a three-run homer here, but one man on and two out. See if he can putting that bat together, bunting, strike on the outside corner. Trying to flip the lineup for Bull, who's on deck. 2-0 GCU. Just in the bottom of the second. Both teams with a couple of hits. Northern Colorado's left three on. The 0-1, and they chase the runner Malice back to second. The pitch, swing and a miss, 0-2. Three games in MLB today, getting things going. Yankees at Rays, Giants at D-backs, and then later on tonight, Cubs at Cardinals. Official opening day of the 2017 season, although it really doesn't open until the Royals play, right? Up the box, fielded nicely by Lidholm, and he pitches underhand for the out. Well, leadoff single does not amount to anything for GCU. No runs on one hit, no errors, and a man left on base. We have completed 2-0 GCU. This is Lopes Baseball on GCU TV.
Earning your RN to BSN degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. Finding your purpose takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over three decades of experience delivering our accredited RN to BSN program 100% online. Graduate in as few as 16 months, learning from full-time practicing nurse faculty in small classes. Integrate your education with your faith and Christian worldview.
Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Thunder watching over Brazel Stadium here as the Lopes are up 2-0. Going to the third. GCU scored both their runs in the first inning after a walk, a bunt single, and a base hit single drove in a run. Evans bringing in Bull. And then a sack fly by Schwartz brought in LaRouge. And that's where we stand at this stage in the ballgame. Top of the order coming up for the Bears. Lawson, Johnson, and Maltese. 0 for 2, those three guys in the game so far. Maltese did reach on a walk. Lawson, a strikeout victim his last time up. He's been a strikeout victim, his leadoff at bat in each ball game in this series. Up high, ball one. Missed inside, 2-0. Lawson 1-for-8 with four strikeouts in this series. That one fouled back. Two balls and one strike to count. It'll pop to the right side. Evans backs onto the grass, makes the grab for the first out.
Left fielder, Evan Johnson.
That'll bring up the left fielder, Evan Johnson. Johnson flew out to right, his first at-bat in this ballgame. Johnson now 0 for 9 in the series. Shot to short. Mumper's got it. Fires across. Two up, two down. Well, Mumper playing that one a bit to the side to get himself into throwing position and the strike over to first. Cole Maltese walked his first at bat against Jack Schneider. Maltese hitting 309 on the year. Six homers, 15 RBI. A lot of power in this lineup for the Bears. Ground ball to third. Ooh, tough hop. Malice, can he recover in time? The throw, not going to get him. Bad hop over there, and they'll credit Maltese with a base hit on that one. Boy, Zach was in position. Just took a weird hop and caromed off his chest. He was unhappy. Thought he had time to get the runner there, but Maltese hustling down the line. So Cole on for the second time in the ball game, and I bring up Jack Pauley. Pauley, a guy who could tie this thing up with one swing of the bat. He does have four homers, 10 doubles, and two triples on the season. And that hit him. Oh, they're going to say stay in the box. Oh, boy. That works out well for the Lopes. I really don't like that call when the umpire does that, but Carl Iwasaki going to come out and have a chat with Gary Gilman, saying he leaned over. That sure looked like it was in the box. Iwasaki arguing and saying that Paulie leaned into it. Kai Correa coming down from third base arguing as well. Like I said, works out for the Lopes. I'd have to agree with Carl Iwasaki on that one. I really not a big fan of that call. But Paulie up there. One ball, no strikes. Fouled back. Well, Pauley trying to make Schneider pay for that one. Going for the downs. So of his 37 hits for Jack Pauley on the season, 16 have been extra base hits. Hitting 381 this year. Pauley hit a chopper to Evans at first. It's last time up. Swing and a miss. Nice breaking pitch tailing away from the lefty. One and two. Two outs. Maltese down there at first. This is where we were when Pauley came up in the first inning. Fouled back, tried to jam him, and Pauley stays alive. The Bears, after this series, are at Air Force on the 4th and then home to take on Seattle in a three-game set in Greeley. Seattle going to be scuffling coming in if they can't get something going. Down 4-0 in the bottom of the third at home. About to get swept by New Mexico State. In the air to right. Coming in. With a sliding catch, Garrison Schwartz makes the final out of the inning. That ball was diving down, but the power of Pauley works against him there as that ball gets into right and Nice play there by Garrison Schwartz. So no runs on one hit. There were no errors and one man left on base. We go to the bottom of the third. GCU leads it 2-0. Well, you can support your fellow classmates and entrepreneurs in this year's Canyon Challenge. The finalists will be presenting their business plans to win a share of $15,000 in total prizes. You can cheer on your favorite business on April 13th at GCU Arena, or just watch it live here on GCU TV. That's the Canyon Challenge, April 13th at GCU Arena, and live on GCU TV. Well, it's pretty obvious they're not going to let me judge that. Could I do the play-by-play on the stream? Is there such a thing? Probably not. Top of the order for GCU, Bull LaRouge Evans. 2-0 Grand Canyon in the third. No score at Bakersfield in the bottom of the third between the Vaqueros and the Roadrunners. Sac State and Utah Valley concluded their three-game series yesterday. They had a doubleheader on Friday. Sac State won both games, 9-1 and then 12-4. And Utah Valley salvaged a game, 7-6, yesterday. So Utah Valley 4-2 in conference play. Sac State 2-4. Austin Bull walked and scored his only time up in this ballgame back in the first. Bull hitting .396 on the year. No homers, 9 RBI, scored 22 runs and 19 walks. Into center, Tanner drifting back, makes the grab for the first out of the inning. Good power displayed there by Bull. Looked like he was jammed a little bit in that ball. Chased Tanner back a few steps. Tom LaRouge had the bunt single in the first, came around to score the second run of the ball game for GCU. Tom in .357, one homer, 9 ribby, fouls that one off. He has scored 9 runs so far this year. Just the 4 extra base hits, the home run, and 3 doubles. Chopper to short. Yamaguchi sets, fires, just in time to get his man. Play by Tyler Yamaguchi out there at short with the speedy LaRouge on the base pass. That'll bring up Ian Evans. So lead home, looking for his first 1-2-3 inning. First inning that he's kept the leadoff man from getting aboard. Evans, a base hit single to drive in a run in the first. Evans hitting .298 on the season. The 1-0. 2-0. Evans now with that base hit. Second base hit of the series. He's 2-for-8 with a run and 5 RBI. Check the swing, and that's in there for a strike. 2 balls and 1 strike to count. Well, those three games we mentioned in MLB today, getting things started, the Yankees and the Rays started off. The Rays up 7-2 on the Yankees in the bottom of the seventh. 3-1 to count to Evans. D-backs hosting the Giants, getting ready to have first pitch in about 20 minutes. Later on tonight, the Cubbies and the Cardinals. Down the right field line, slicing, and that'll get foul. 3-2 to count now. So Ian will make the long walk back. And that Rays-Yankees game, Tanaka getting the start. I don't think he made it out of the third inning. Down the line, that's fair trouble, fair ball. It's going to roll into the corner, bounce around. Pauly out there, fields it cleanly. 2-out double for Ian Evans.
Right field.
Well, he was flirting with that right field line on the fly ball. That time, he gets it to stay fair, and that'll bring up Gary with two outs and a man in scoring position. Evans' seventh double, starting to heat up here. It's 2-for-2 in the ball game. Started the season hot, has chilled a bit. Maybe getting it going here. Schwartz had the sack fly to drive in a run back in the first. So officially 0-for-0. Tried to check his swing, but he went around. Strike one. In the dirt, blocked nicely by Keel. 1-1. Schwartz, the preseason WAC player of the year, the 1-1. Chopper right side, Lawson waits for it. Fires the first, and that is the inning. So Gary grounds out 4-3 to end the inning. And the Lopes, no runs on one hit. There are no errors and a man left on base. We've completed 3-2-0 GCU. This is Lopes Baseball on GCU TV.
I'm Dominique. I'm a student here at Grand Canyon University studying hospitality management. My hospitality courses here are giving me a high-quality education from professors that I know have been successful. Being able to work while I'm in school has enriched my college experience. I feel like I know where I'm going and what I want to do. When they say find your purpose, they mean it.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Two nothing GCU as we head to the fourth inning here. No runs, three hits, no errors, four left on base for Northern Colorado. Two runs, four hits, no errors, and two left on for GCU. For the Bears, Minnick, Tanner, and Burkhart, 5, 6, and 7, due up against Jack Schneider, the starter for Grand Canyon. Well, we told you that the Bears have a road game at Air Force, then their next WAC competition, a three-game set hosting Seattle. Seattle has put a couple runs on the board now and trail it 4-2 as we are in the top of the fourth up in Seattle. GCU become the Road Warriors once again after this ball game. Playing 8 of their next 9 on the road. Minnick lined out to third, his first at bat. Gets under that one, pops it right side. Evans coming over into foul ground. Out number one. Well, one pitch, one out. Nick Tanner, base hit single. His last time up in this ballgame. The Lopes at Arkansas, the 20th ranked team in the country, April 4th and 5th. Then they head straight to California at Sac State in WAC play. Come home for one against Arizona, and then at Chicago State, the 13th through the 15th. Breaking pitch, strike one. Next time they'll be back for a WAC series, April 21st through the 23rd, hosting UTRGV. In the air to left, Wyatt. Makes a grab for out number two. Matt Burkhart, base hit single his last time up. 1-for-1. Have we ever hosted UTRGV? It was UTPA last time we hosted them, correct? University of Texas Pan American or University of Texas Rio Grande Valley? Rio Grande Valley. I've been there. It's Grande. The 1-0. 1-1. Were they the Broncos? The Bronx? And now they're the Vaqueros? The 1-1. So we're going to miss 1-2. Our good friend Jonah Goldberg with UTRGV. Probably watching this game as he's watching his team up in Bakersfield. So we're going to miss strike three. Second strike out of the ball game for Schneider. Gets him 1-2-3 here in the fourth. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. 2-0 GCU. Check out companies on campus next week in the Student Union. Network with different companies. Learn about jobs and internships. Maybe even land a job. For more information, contact Career Services at gcu.edu or follow them on Facebook for future opportunities at facebook.com/gcucareerservices. That's companies on campus, Career Services at gcu.edu. Well, in the top of the fourth, a 1-2-3 inning for Schneider. That's his first 1-2-3 inning of the ball game. Lopes will send up Wyatt Malice and Signs with a two-run lead. In the first two ball games, Lopes were able to get out early in front of the Bears and then tack on extra runs to distance themselves. Need to start doing that here. Two runs, obviously not enough, you would think, against these Bears with the power that they have in their lineup. Although the Lopes have limited that power, the Bears with 22 home runs on the season. Seventeen of those home runs for the Bears in the first 13 games. Just five home runs since. Wyatt to lead off for GCU. Tyler grounded into the 6-4-3 double play to end the first. One and zero to Wyatt. Tyler, 3-for-7 now in the series. Three runs scored, two RBI. Breaking pitch, nicely done by Leadholm in there. 1-1. Base hit by Wyatt. On the 1-1 pitch, just takes it back up the middle. So Wyatt gets the base knock for GCU. That's a fifth hit of the ball game for the Lopes. That'll bring up Zach Malice. Wyatt takes his lead. Malice, base hit single, first at bat. The 1-0. There goes Wyatt in the dirt. Oh, and Malice swung at it, fouled it off. Well, the ball was in the dirt. Malice, for some reason, on a little hit and run there, took a cut at it, fouled it off, and Wyatt goes back to first. That goes to 1-1 on Zach Malice. Don't see that very often. That one bounced about 5 feet out in front of the plate, and Zach got a piece of it on the carom. Throw over and Wyatt back. Wyatt 0-for-1 in stolen bases this season. Lopes haven't had to run a ton in this series, but they're 4-for-4 when they have. Not going. Oh, that one's ripped to right. Going back is Pauly looking up, and it's out of here. Well, the way Pauly reacted, it looked like he had a bead on it, but, man, that was crushed by Malice. Malice, first home run of the season, brings in two, and it's 4-0 GCU. Well, Malice upset himself for swinging at that pitch in the dirt. Makes amends right there with a couple of RBI on his first home run of the year. That'll bring up Signs, still with nobody out, and now nobody on, thanks to Zach Malice. Signs a ground out to third. in his first at-bat in this ball game. Lidholm getting a few words from his catcher, Kyle. Malis had three home runs last year in his freshman campaign where he hit 301. Amassed 41 hits, 24 RBIs, and three long balls. His first here of the season. First pitch to Sines in there, strike one. Well outside, 1-1. So the Lopes used the long ball to get the lead in the game yesterday. A three-run shot by Mumper in the second. The ball definitely traveling better. Check swing went around. 1-2. Ball definitely traveling better in the daytime than it did on Friday night. Trying to make Sines an aggressive hitter. Reach for that one, but he wouldn't. 2-2 count. Right back up the box for a base hit. Boy, that'll get the adrenaline going if you're the pitcher, 60 feet 6 inches away, even closer after you release the ball. Jake Wong had one of those. The last hit he gave up in the ball game on Friday night, sizzle right past him. I asked him later in the game, I said, you know, he smacked his glove after. I said, were you upset you knew you were coming out, or were you upset because you thought you should have got a glove on? And he said, no, there's no way. I was just trying to get out of the way on that one. Same thing there for Lidholm, and that might be it. R.D. Spies out to chat with them. There's action in the pen. Looks like number six, Sam Leach, the freshman righty out of Seattle, Washington, and Nathan Hale High School. We have a trivia question up here in the box. The Nathan Hale basketball team? It's got to be the Patriots, right? Oh, I thought you meant their nickname. Who's the high school coach of Nathan Hale High School basketball? Boy, that's a tough one. Brandon Roy. There you go. I did not have the background rooting interest that would allow me to know the answer to that question. Is he any good? That's the question. State champs this year, we think. We're going to effort to formalize that response. Nobody out. Two runs already across. Man on first, Sines, and Meyer steps in. First pitch, strike one. So Spies having a chat with Connor Lidholm. 29-0. State champs, national coach of the year. So he's pretty good. What's their mascot? That one misses away, 1-1. Meyer, a ground out to third. I'd be very disappointed if it's not the Patriots. The Raiders? Nathan Hale. He was a Patriot, not a Raider. Come on. Chop foul. Ooh, nice grab on the carom, the pitching coach. Rich Dorman snagged that one. One ball, two strike to Meyer. 4-0 GCU. Two in the first and now two here in the fourth. Just missed on the outside corner. Meyer hitting 250 on the season. Still looking for his first homer of the year. Missed outside. Count goes full. Three balls and two strikes to Josh Meyer. Leach continues to warm in the bullpen. With nobody out, getting a little dicey for the Bears here. Throw over. Runner dives back safely. That's Greg Sines, the DH. Meyer, one home run in his collegiate career, came in 2014, his freshman campaign. 3-2. There goes the runner inside. Ball four. Actually hit him, so it'll go down as an HBP. Runners at first and second. That'll bring up Mumper with two on. We've seen Mumper do well with a couple guys on. Lopes trying to blow it wide open here. Already up 4-0 with nobody out here in the fourth inning. Mumper, a ground out back to the pitcher. Bunting up high, ball one. Oh, he's in there for a strike, actually. Looked a little high. Stankiewicz going through the signs down there at third base. The skipper in his sixth season, a record of 165, 129, and 1, has already won the conference once, just his fourth year in the conference. So one time in three tries. Mumper bunting again. Gets the bunt down. Oh, it's a good one. Lidholm's got one play. Bare hands it, throws just in time to get Mumper. Bang, bang play at first does not go the way of the Lopes, but Mumper. A sack bunt, 1-3 on the putout. Sines moves over to third. Meyer now down at second. Top of the order, Austin Bull. Bull 0 for 1, a walk and scored a run in the first. Flew out to center in the third. Austin hitting 392 on the year. 487 on base percentage, but hitting 351 with runners on and 364 with runners in scoring position. Swing and a miss on a breaking pitch. Owen won the count to Bull. Coming into this game, Bull and LaRouge were 8 for 15 with 5 runs, 5 ribbies, 5 walks, 3 for 3 in stolen bases. They've already each scored once here in this one. Outside, 1-1. Bull just the consummate baseball guy, always working on his game. Loves learning more about the game. A lot of books he reads are about baseball, about hitting. Always working on his craft and shows here this year, his sophomore campaign, off to a great start. Down low, 2-1. Very patient, willing to take a lot of pitches. Perfect leadoff man for the Lopes. When we talked to Coach Stankiewicz prior to the ball game, he said that these leadoff guys have been fantastic for GCU because they just watch, they look at so many pitches and get to see what the pitcher's got and where the strike zone is. The 2-1, well outside, 3-1. And yes, the strike zone's not supposed to change, but it does, depending on who's behind the plate. And so after an inning with the catcher, he can kind of tell you where the pitches are getting called strikes, and as many pitches as Bull and LaRouge usually see, they can tell you as well. 3-1. Should get a good one here. Did not. Bases loaded now after the second walk of the day to Austin Bull, and that might be it for Lidholm. R.D. Spees makes the pitching changes. He's standing right down there. Had to adjust his belt before he came out and made the change. And we are going to get a pitching change here. That'll be it for Connor Lidholm. So Lidholm will leave with the bases loaded and down 4-0 here in the fourth inning. So 3 1/3 for Lidholm, but he's responsible for everybody out there. And it's going to be number 6, Sam Leach, the ex-Raider from Nathan Hale High School. We'll get you Leach's numbers here on in relief. Sam Leach, this will be his 7th appearance. He does have 2 starts to his name this year. A 2.38 ERA. In 11 and a third, he's given up 12 hits, 4 runs, 3 earned. He's walked 4 and struck out 4. Opposition 279 against Leach. He's given up 3 extra base hits. They were all doubles. So Leach is going to come in and inherit quite the jam here as the Lopes have the bases loaded, already up 4-0. You got Sines at third. He reached on a single after the home run by Malice. You got Meyer at second. He was hit by a pitch on a 3-2 count. And then you've got Bull at first after the walk. Still a 4-2 ball game up in Seattle in the bottom of the fourth, but Seattle's got a couple of men on with two outs. 1-0 Vaqueros over the runners in the bottom of the fourth up in Bakersfield. We got a 4-0 ball game here, but the Lopes threatening to blow it wide open. And you've got Chicago State losing at home to Eastern Michigan by a score of 3-1 in the seventh. Tom LaRouge coming up to the plate, hitting 351 on the year. One homer, has 9 RBI. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Had a bunt single in the first and scored a run and ground out to short in the third. Bases loaded, one out, 4-0 Lopes here in the bottom of the fourth. First pitch from Leach. LaRouge goes after it, blasts it deep into left center field. Evans makes the grab. Tag it at third is Sines. He'll come in to score, and the sack fly makes it a 5-0 ball game. So LaRouge wasting no time on the sack fly to left. Everybody else holds. That'll bring up Ian Evans. Evans already with a couple of base hits and an RBI. Evans a base hit single to bring in Bull in the first and a double in the third. Painted that right field line. First pitch from Leach. Breaking ball up high. Ball one. Evans now with 19 RBI on the season. Leads the Lopes in that category. Schwartz a couple behind him with 17. The 1-0. Missed outside. 2-0. Evans hitting 305 on the season. It was 19 RBI, 7 doubles, and 1 home run on the year for Evans. Good numbers with the runners on. And there for a strike, 2-1. Evans hitting 341 with runners on base, 387 with runners in scoring position, and 440 with two outs. 2-1 count. Not holding Bull on there at first, trying to keep Meyer close at second. Dean Lawson, the second baseman, in the vicinity. Ground ball right side, not sharply hit. Lawson's got it, weird hop, but stays with it. Throws over to first to end the inning. But the Lopes get 3 runs on 3 hits. The biggest, the 2-run homer by Zach Malice. And no errors, 2 left on base. We go to the fifth. 5-0 GCU with the lead. This is Lopes Baseball on GCU TV.
Time. Time never stops, never slows down. We spend time on the things we love and the people who need us. The time we spend is precious. And before we know it, it's gone. But every end has the promise of a new beginning. It's time to create a better future. A new beginning awaits. Seize it. GCU's online degree program puts you first, so you can make the most of your time. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University.
Five nothing Lopes here as we go to the fifth inning. GCU trying to go a perfect 6-0 in conference play and their second sweep of the year, seemingly within reach. Jack Schneider back on the hill. He'll face 8-9-1. Keel, Yamaguchi, and Lawson due up for this Bears squad that came in a perfect 3-0 in the conference and now staring down the barrel of a 3-3 record here. A sweep and then possibly getting swept here. Bears swept the Lopes in Greeley last year. GCU trying to return the favor here. Once you get to into WAC play, all bets are off. I mean, a lot of folks, this Northern Colorado team was picked to finish eighth. And they sweep Sac State in the first weekend. Now possibly getting swept here by the Lopes, who were picked to finish fourth. Pitch inside, almost hit him, but Keel gets out of the way. Snyder having a good outing here for GCU. That one fouled off, 1-1, going to get out of play into the bullpen area. Snyder in four innings has given up three hits, one walk, two Ks, faced 16 batters and thrown 52 pitches, 35 of those strikes, 10 first pitch strikes for Snyder. The 1-1, fouled off again down the right side. One gets into the pen as well. Lopes picked to finish fourth in the conference. Northern Colorado eighth. Seattle was picked to finish first. And they're right now just trying to salvage a game and not get swept at home against New Mexico State. Line drive into center coming on LaRue. She'll play it on a bounce. So Keogh gets the base knock. Leadoff man aboard for the first time in the ball game for the Bears. That'll bring up the number 9 leader, Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi had a solo homer in the ball game yesterday. For Keel, that was his first base hit of the series. He's now 1-for-8. Yamaguchi 1-for-5 in this series with that solo homer. Bunting. They're going to let that roll, maybe, and it does roll foul. When Malice hustled in on it, had to let it continue to roll, probably got a little bit nervous because Malice himself came up and bunted a ball the other night, saw the shift was on, nobody down there by third, so he bunted it toward third, and it rolled and rolled and hit the edge of that grass and was going to kick foul, but it bounced off the bag to be a fair ball. Got himself a bunt single. That one, boy, sure looked like he was trying to stay fair. Almost hit the bag, but luckily for the Lopes, wide 0-1 to Yamaguchi. Fouls it off 0-2. Yamaguchi on the season 226, the sophomore shortstop, two homers, 9 RBI. Got 21 hits, but he struck out 22 times. Snyder's got him set up here with an 0-2 count. See if he tries to get him to chase something. Up high, he does. But Yamaguchi will not chase it. 1-2 the count. Top of the ninth, the Rays looking to get first win of the Major League Baseball season, up 7-2 on the Yankees. That one ripped to left. I think he might have got another one. Looking up is Wyatt. He finally finds it, and it's off that screen above the wall for a second home run of the series for Tyler Yamaguchi. And once again, the Lopes just came into him, and the ball elevated a bit. That's what happened with Repovich as well. The lefty coming in, and Yamaguchi did not miss it. So it's a 5-2 ball game. Well, not often that you see a number 9 hole hitter that you got to be wary of, but Yamaguchi with displaying good power here. And it's 5-2. Top of the order, still nobody out here in the fifth. Got some action down in the pen for GCU. Swing and a miss by Lawson. I'm guessing, is that Andrews down there in the pen? It's Josh Andrews down in the pen getting ready. Another lefty for the Lopes. Lawson 0-for-2 in this one. A strikeout and a pop out. 1-1. Lawson has started all 25 games for the Bears, the 1-1. Starting the 26th here. 1-2. Lawson 1-for-9 in this series. The 1-2. Breaking pitch up high. The 2-2 in the air to right. Ball slicing away, but Gary's there. Makes a grab for the first out of the inning. Stankiewicz going to come out. Looks like that's going to do it. That'll be the day for Schneider. Schneider gets through 4 1/3. And it's going to be Josh Andrews coming in, the sophomore lefty from Queen Creek. So the two-run homer, really the kiss of death for Jack Schneider here. He leaves the ballgame after 4 1/3. 5 hits, 2 runs. They were both earned. He walked one and struck out two. 65 pitches, 44 were strikes. And we turn to the reliever. So Josh Andrews into the ballgame. I'll give you his numbers in just a moment here. Second pitcher of the day for the Lopes here in the fifth. Josh Andrews, number 31, the 5'11 sophomore out of Queen Creek, Arizona, and Queen Creek High School. Andrews, this will be his 11th appearance, all out of the bullpen. An ERA of 1.12. 8 innings pitched, 6 hits, 1 run. It was earned. He's walked 3 and struck out 9. Opposition in 222 against Josh, and no extra base hits. So Andrews into the ballgame now to take over with a 5-2 lead. Yankees trying to make a bit of a comeback, down 7-2 with a couple guys on in the top of the ninth. Nobody out. Chris Archer got the start for the Rays, in line for the victory. D-backs underway here just downtown. No score, but a couple of guys on for the Giants in the top of the first. Greinke in a bit of a jam. Bring up Evan Johnson. He'll be the first guy to face Josh Andrews. Evan Johnson has struggled, to say the least. He's 0-for-10 in the series. Nobody on. Lopes lead at 5-2. First pitch, strike one to Johnson. And we talked to Coach Stankiewicz, and he said he just wants their guys to compete. And I said, what are you looking for? How do you know when one of your guys is competing? And he said, throwing strikes. You got to trust your stuff and throw strikes. So Andrew starts with a strike and then a ball. 1-1 the count. We're in the fifth. Strike two, 1-2. Getaway day for the Bears here. Bears will head home and then drive over to play Air Force on Tuesday, up high, 2-2. The Lopes will fly out and play Arkansas on Tuesday and Wednesday. The 2-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Looks like that one's a little high and out of the zone, but chased it. First strike out of the ballgame for Andrews, third of the game for Lopes pitchers. Remember Cole Maltese. Maltese been on base twice in the ballgame today. Both those at bats, though, against Schneider. fouled that one off. Maltese walked in the first and singled in the third and never advanced past first base. Up high and away. 1-1. Fouled off. Up high at the 1-2. Makes it a 2-2 count now to Cole Maltese. Maltese hitting 316 with six homers. Fouls it off. Count stays. Two balls and two strikes. Lopes wanted strike three on that breaking pitch. Didn't get the call from Gary Gilman. So the count goes full. Three balls and two strikes with two outs here in the fifth. Walked him. Second time in the day that Maltese has reached on a walk. Third time he's been on base. That'll bring up Jack Pauley. Pauley had a ground out to first in the first inning. Flew out to right on a nice play by Garrison Schwartz, a sliding catch to retire him. That was his second at bat in the third inning. A pie ball one. Maltese taking his lead. Not a big lead. Held on by Evans. The 1-0. Big rip. Fouled straight back on it, just under it a bit. 1-1 the count to Jack Pauley. Pauley hitting 378, slugging 643 on the season. Four homers, 10 doubles, two triples. Andrews, check, the 1-1. Strike on the outside corner, bit of a laid call there, Pauley. Jerks his head back. Looked like a good pitch, but Gilman just a little late on that call. Pauley was hit by a pitch back in the third, but Gary Gilman told him he couldn't head down to the bag, that he leaned his arm out there. Tried to lean his arm out there that time. Ball missed him, though. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs here in the fifth. There goes the runner. Throw down, high, not in time. So Maltese on a 2-2 count steals the bag. The count goes full, three balls and two strikes. So Cole Maltese with his fifth steal of the year. He's 5 for 5 in stolen bases. Andrews needing to end it right here. Minnick on deck. The 3-2. Strike three called. Pauley was heading down. I'm not sure what he was looking at. That looked like a really good pitch from up here. I'll tell you, that didn't look like any question on that one. And Pauley looking back at the home plate umpire, but Gary Gilman has gone the other direction. So Andrews comes in and strikes out two, walks one, but pitches around after coming in after a two-run homer. However, the Bears inch closer in that inning with the two-run homer by Tyler Yamaguchi, and it's a 5-2 ball game as we go to the bottom of the fifth here at Brazel. Well, you can get the best gear to show off your Lope pride. Go to lopeshops.gcu.edu to find everything GCU, from the newest apparel to the coolest accessories. Use promo code GCUTV20. Get 20% off for being a GCU TV viewer. Let's paint the valley purple. Lopes up. So both teams have gone to their bullpen. And Leach back out there for the Bears. Lopes lead at 5-2 here in the bottom of the fifth. Lidholm, the starter for the Bears, went 3 1/3 innings. Gave up 7 hits, 5 runs, all 5 were earned. He walked 2, didn't strike out anybody. And Lidholm gave way to Leach, who got the last 2 outs of the inning. Schwartz, Wyatt, and Malice due up for GCU. First pitch, a strike in there to Garrison Schwartz. Schwartz 0 for 1. Had a sac fly to drive in LaRouge in the first. Ground out to second in the third. High and away 1-1. The 1-1. Two on the count now to Garrison Schwartz. To the right side, high hop, plays it off the chest. The pitch in time. Nice recovery there by Minnick. We've seen a couple of weird hops at the corners. One Malice had to play off his chest, and one now that Minnick had to do the same. Minnick able to keep it close enough that he could bring it back. So leadoff man retired for the Lopes. That'll bring up Tyler Wyatt. Wyatt ground into a double play in the first. A base hit single and scored a run in the fourth. Ball one. Two and oh now to Wyatt. So Wyatt now 1-for-2 in this ball game. Missed inside, 3-0. Wyatt now 4-for-8 in the series, 4 runs scored. In there for a strike right down the middle. 3-1 the count to Tyler Wyatt. Wyatt hitting 333 on the season, the 3-1. And he walked him. So Wyatt gets aboard for the second time in the ball game with the walk. First walk by Leach. First batter he hasn't retired. That'll bring up Zach Malice. Malice, the big blow, the two-run homer is last time up. He's 2-for-2 in this one. A base hit single and a two-run shot in the fourth. Fouled it straight back. Well, the Yankees not going away here. It's a 7-3 ball game. In the ninth, they got 2 men on. Just 1 out. Maybe 2 outs now. One and one the count. Grinke got out of the inning unscathed, so no score in the bottom of the first for the Diamondbacks. Wyatt takes his lead. The 1-1 throws over and Wyatt back. Wyatt was stealing on the pitch before the homer by Malice, and it was a pitch in the dirt, and Malice fouled it off on the bounce. Wyatt had to come back, and then Malice hit the two-run shot. The 1-1. Wyatt not going. It would have been a good one to run on as that was low and inside. But count goes to 2 balls and 1 strike, and that is always a good count to do something on here. 1 out in the fifth, 5-2 GCU. Not going. Ripped again, but pulled foul. Really got the barrel out ahead in that one, but would have been his second home run of the day and of the year. Malice hitting 259 on the season with that one home run and does have 4 doubles to his name. 14 RBI. the 2-2. Up high. Calgo's full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Now we'll see if Coach Tankiewicz wants to get the runner going. A lot of times he will with just one out. So you put yourself in the position for a strike him out, throw him out, but you also get the runner moving and possibly take him out of the double play. Wyatt with his lead, not a huge lead. The throw over, and he's back. There goes the runner. Low and inside. Ball 4. So back-to-back walks. Surrendered by Leach. The Lopes have runners on first and second with signs coming to the plate. Boy, walks will kill you, and the Bears have had trouble. 7-3, Rays beat the Yankees. Get the first win of the 2017 season. Visit on the mound by Keel, and now signs at the plate. Signs, 1-for-2, ground out to third in the second. The base hit single in the fourth and came in to score on the sack fly by LaRouge. Rips it up the middle. Wyatt had to hold, but now he's on his horse. He's going to come around. The throw's going to go into third. Malice slides in, and Sines takes second on the throw. 6-2 GCU. Sines with an RBI single. Good to see GCU continuing to apply the pressure here. Wyatt wisely with just one out, wanted to make sure that ball wasn't caught. So he took his first step back to second, but with his speed, easily able to come around and score. And Malice, running hard with the ball in front of him, had a better view of whether that was catchable. And he was into third before the throw. Sines takes second on the throw. Meyer at the plate with 2 more in scoring position. Ground ball left side, gloved, and then kicked by Yamaguchi. So back-to-back base hit singles by Sines and now Meyer produce runs and a 7-2 GCU. Malice comes in to score. Sines moves down to third. So Meyer just going after the first pitch, putting it in play, and good things happening. Tough play by Yamaguchi. Probably save a run by not letting that get into the outfield. That'll be it for Leach. Well, in the ballgame last night, they used 6 pitchers on pitcher number 3 here. And Leach is done. Looks like it's going to be number 9, Isaac Bracken, the freshman out of Berthoud, Colorado. So Bracken in to throw. I believe we saw Bracken up in the bullpen the other day. Didn't get into the ball game, though. Bracken, a 4.91 ERA. This is his 5th appearance. In 7 1/3, 11 hits, 7 runs, 4 earned. He's walked 1 and struck out 8. Opposition in 367 against Bracken. And would that be Berthoud, Colorado? Is that how you pronounce that? Probably. Berthoud, Colorado? And Berthoud High School. Who's the head basketball coach at Berthoud High School? Would it be an ex-Denver Nugget, possibly? So the Lopes piling them on here. They got 2 in the first after a walk and a bunt single by Bull and LaRouge. They got the RBI single by Evans, a sack fly by Schwartz. We're up 2-0. Then they scored 3 in the fourth, a single by Wyatt, a 2-run homer. A blast over the right center field wall by Malice, his first of the year. And then a base hit single by Sines. Meyer was hit by a pitch. A couple of batters later with the bases loaded, a sack fly by LaRouge, and it was 5-0. Then in the top of this inning, a leadoff single by Keel, and then a two-run homer by Tyler Yamaguchi, his second homer of the series, made it 5-2. Lopes have answered with a couple here and still at it with one out and runners at the corners. Both men who've walked, Wyatt and Malice, have scored, and Mumper, the first to face Bracken, first pitch, outside ball one. Bracken out of Colorado, Mumper out of Colorado as well. Wonder if they ever cross paths. Outside, 2-0 to Mumper. Top of the order on deck. Mumper 0-for-1. And a ground out to the pitcher and then a sack bunt. Outside 3-0. So Bracken trying to work the outside part of the plate, but just too far outside. That went in there for a strike, 3-1. That one hit well by Mumper. Deep left center field coming over. That ball's going to find the wall in between a couple of defenders. Sign's going to come in to score. Meyer was holding up to make sure that thing was going to fall, but Josh turns on the Jets, and a two-run double by Mark Mumper. Hit it to the deepest part of the ballpark, 380 out there in the left center field power alley. Gave it a ride, and Sign's and Meyer come in to score easily. Mumper picks up his third double of the season and his 10th RBI. 9-2 GCU. Mumper continuing to produce. Top of the order coming up. And boy, I tell you, if he can keep doing that, he will find himself in the lineup the rest of the season. First pitch down low in the dirt. Ball one to Bull. Bull hitting 392 on the year, 0-for-1 in this one, but has been on base twice with walks. Inside for a strike. Already 4 runs on 3 hits in this inning for GCU. They got 10 hits in the ball game. Chopped right side, foul ball. 1-2 to Bull. Well, Lopes flirted with that 10-run mercy rule in the ball game yesterday. We're an out away from getting it. And Northern Colorado went back-to-back doubles in an air, produced a couple of runs to keep them in the ball game. Foul back. Boy, Bull was on that one. 1-2, the count remains. They're up 7 here. The 1-2 from Bracken. Mumper takes his lead at second. Ground ball right side, foul. So Giants strike first, 1-0 in the top of the second on a sack fly from Joe Panic to bring home Eduardo Nunez. The 1-2. Inside, 2-2. Boy, Bull's got a fantastic eye up there at the plate. Already on the season, 20 walks. on base percentage climbing up there close to 50%. 2-2. Ground ball. Gloved. Boy, Mumper took off on contact there and made it to third. Kind of took Bracken by surprise. By the time he looked back there, Mumper was halfway down to third base. So Mumper moves up to third. Bull retired 1-3 for the second out of the inning. That'll bring up Tom LaRouge. LaRouge, a sack fly his last time up. RBI drove in Greg Sines with a fifth run of the ballgame. Ground out to short in the third and reached on a bunt and scored in the first. First pitch misses ball one. Foul back. One and one the count now to Tom LaRouge. Tom hitting 351. He's got that one homer with 10 RBI. Has scored 9 runs. 2-1. 4 runs already across on just 3 hits for GCU. That's in this inning alone. So we're going to miss on an off-speed pitch. Looked tantalizing up high, and LaRouge couldn't hold off. The 2-2 in the dirt, 3-2. Mumper down the line, making sure that that ball was stopped by Alex Keel, the catcher. One of the Lopes we mentioned, two players on the preseason All-WAC team, Garrison Schwartz and Zach Malice. Schwartz, the player of the year. And for the Bears, nobody on the All-WAC team. A lot of Seattle, New Mexico State guys in the air. Little looper, Yamaguchi going out. Going out, makes the grab, and that is the inning. So LaRouge pops out to end the inning. But 4 runs on 3 hits. There were no errors. And 1 left on base. We have completed 5-9-2 GCU. This is Lopes Baseball on GCU TV.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
New pitcher on the hill for GCU, number 29, A.J. Franks. So Andrews comes in and strikes out 2, does give a walk to get out of the 5th inning. But A.J. Franks on the mound now for GCU. Can tell Coach Stankiewicz just wants to put this one away here and keep the Bears at bay. Franks, a 6'2" senior out of Anaheim, California, played at Kennedy High and Santa Ana College. A.J., this is his 15th appearance all out of the pen in 24 innings. Has a 3.38 ERA, a record of 2-0 and 1 save to his credit. 26 hits, 10 runs, 9 earned. He's walked 3 and struck out 13. Opposition 286 against A.J. He's given up 4 doubles, no triples, and no home runs. Minnick, Tanner, and Burkhart due up to face A.J. Franks. Franks in the series has thrown an inning and 2/3, given up 1 hit and struck out 1. That 1 hit was a double. Little tapper, going to be a tough play. Malice comes in and fields it, but it was off the foot of Minnick, so it's a foul ball. Fouled off. Minnick down to the count, no balls and 2 strikes. He's 0-for-2 today, hitting .280 on the year with a couple of homers. Does have 16 RBI and 14 runs scored. But Minnick today, a line out to third and a pop out in foul territory to Ian Evans at first. way outside from Franks, and Minnick wouldn't chase it. The 1-2 from the side armor. Just missed outside. That one framed by Meyer. Meyer's doing a nice job of framing those pitches, holding on to those pitches. Got to be careful, though. You don't want to hold on to them too long and upset the umpire. When fouled back, count stays 2 balls and 2 strikes. The 2-2 from A.J. Swing and a miss, struck him out. So relievers have come in, and in 4 batters, they've struck out 3. Franks gets his first K of the ball game. I'll bring up Nick Tanner. Tanner, a single in the second, and a fly out to left in the 4th. Tanner in 242 on the season. Missed outside, ball 1. Ground ball to 2nd. Bull has it. Delivers it to 1st in plenty of time. So 2 up and 2 down for the reliever, A.J. Franks, here in the 6th with GCU up 9-2. I bring up Matt Burkhart. Burkhart, the freshman third baseman, singled in the 2nd, struck out in the 4th, so 1-for-2 on the day for Burkhart. Now they're trying to get the defense situated. Mumper was directing traffic. LaRouge coming over to basically straight up the middle of center field. First pitch to Burkhart in there for strike 1. Burkhart 3-for-8 on the series, has struck out a couple of times. Little chopper. Franks has it, gloves it, turns, fires in time for the out. A 1-2-3 inning for A.J. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. We go to the bottom of the 6th, 9-2 GCU. Hey, if you're on campus, check out GCBC for locally sourced. No action down in the bullpen for GCU. Schneider went 4 1/3. Andrews went 2/3. And now A.J. Franks goes a clean inning here in the 6th and got him 1-2-3. Lopes lead at 9-2 as we go to the bottom of the 6th. Evans, Schwartz, and Wyatt do up against a new pitcher. Last night the Bears used 6. This is number 4 for them now. Anthony Brady, the 5'11". Junior righty out of Idaho Falls, Idaho, and the University of Puget Sound. Anthony Brady, this is his 9th appearance. He's got 3 saves in 9 innings. He's given up 1 hit, 1 run. It was unearned. 8 walks, 13 Ks. So the closer for the Bears coming in here in a situation where he's just trying to hold the Lopes and give his team a shot here. With GCU up 9-2. 2 runs, 5 hits, no errors, and 5 left on for the Bears. 9 runs, 10 hits, no errors, and 5 left on for GCU. So Anthony Brady, your new pitcher for the Bears. Evans 2-for-3, Schwartz 0-for-2, and Wyatt 1-for-2. Evans hitting 302 on the season now. Had a base hit single that produced a run in the first, doubled in the third, and ground out to second in the fourth. Ball one. Evans with five RBI now in the series. Foul tipped into the mitt, 1-1. Lopes sent eight to the plate last inning. Evans was on deck when LaRouge popped out. Would have been the ninth hitter of the inning. The 1-1. Up high with the breaking pitch. 2-1. Three and one, the count now to Evans. The 3-1 pitch. Ripped into left for a base hit. If it gets by the outfielder to the wall, which it does, could be a double. Very quickly tossed back in by Johnson, but Evans slides into second with his second double and third hit of the ball game. Well, Evan Johnson played it well out there, but Evans was thinking two from the crack of the bat. So leadoff man aboard and in scoring position. For Evans, he picks up his seventh double of the season. Schwartz up. Evans down at second. Pitch to Gary. Inside ball one. Schwartz 0 for 2 today. Had the sac fly in the first, but then a ground out to second. And then in the fifth inning, little ground out on the infield. The 1-0 to Garrison. Inside, almost hit him. Gets away from the catcher. Evans moves up to third easily. The wild pitch by Brady puts Evans 90 feet away. 2-0 count to Garrison Schwartz. Down low, 3-0. Well, the Rays have already won here today, in the first win of the season. The Giants up 1-0 on the D-backs, Greinke and Bumgarner. The 3-0. 3-1. Mad Bum seems locked in here. Greinke scuffling a bit in the third. Down the line. Fair ball. Evans is going to score. Gary looking for two. Trouble in left field by Johnson, but Schwartz just cruises in the second. Back-to-back doubles by GCU, and it is 10-2. Schwartz picks up his second RBI of the day. He's trying to track down Ian Evans. Evans with one RBI today puts him at 19. Schwartz now with two puts him at 18. I'll bring up Tyler Wyatt. So nobody out here in the bottom of the sixth. 8-run lead for the Lopes. Up high, ball one. The problem for Brady is he's just been pitching behind everybody, so he's got to come to him with a good pitch. And Schwartz able to slice that one down the left field line for the double. The 1-0. Breaking pitch in there for a strike. That's a sixth double on the season for Schwartz. He's second on the team, trailing just Ian Evans with seven. Or actually eight, because Evans has two today. The 1-1. Another good breaking pitch in there for a strike. That one froze Wyatt a bit. Tyler Wyatt, 1-for-2 with a couple of runs scored. Had the ground into a double play in the first, a single, and scored a run in the fourth, and walked and scored in the sixth. In the fifth, I should say. The 1-2. Ground ball, left side. Yamaguchi under his glove and into left field. And Schwartz wisely and a little bit aggressively takes the bag. So Wyatt on with the single to left, and Gary moves up to third. Thirteen hits for GCU now. Malice at the plate. Hopes need a couple more runs here and could end this game early. Had a chance yesterday to do that. Weren't able to get it done. But Malice can do here. Still nobody out in the inning. First pitch strike. Zach Malice having a nice day today, to say the least. He's 2-for-2. Had a single. Two-run homer in the fourth. Walked and scored in the fifth. The 0-1. Up high around the eyes. 1-1. So Wyatt now 2-for-3 on the day with a walk as well. Been on base three times. The 1-1, low and inside. 2-1 to Malice. Good hitting count here. Lefty starting to get loose in the bullpen for the Bears. Back pick down to first, not in time. Cal goes with 3-1 on Malice. Looks like he's at Carver Pate down there. 39. Pate has already pitched in this series. Getting loose. 3-1 pitch to Malice. And he walked him. Bases loaded for Greg Sines. So Malice has been on base all four plate appearances. A single, a homer, and two walks. He's on base again. Signs up with the bases loaded. I think they might go to Pate here, even though it would be a lefty-righty matchup, but Spees now. Nope, going to go through the signs. Brady is going to pitch. Pate threw an inning and a third in his one appearance. Struck out a couple. Didn't allow any runs and one base hit, but he's not coming in here. Signs, 2-for-3, back-to-back base hit singles. Up high, ball one. After a ground out to third, his first at-bat, Signs got a base hit single and scored in the fourth, drove in a run with a single and scored in the eighth. Bases full of Lopes here, already up 10-2, fouled back, 1-1. The 1-1. Breaking pitch just missed. 2-1 the count to Greg Sines. Meyer on deck. Evans led off the inning with the double. Came around to score on the double by Schwartz. Wyatt had a base hit single, pushed Gary to third, and then the walk to Malice loaded the bases. Into right. One run will score. That's Schwartz. They're going to hold everybody up and go station to station here. 11-2 GCU. The base is still loaded and nobody out here in the sixth. Sines picks up his third single in a row and his second RBI of the day. And I think we're going to see Carver Pate. So Gary comes in to score. Makes it an 11-2 ball game. Everybody else moves up a notch. Wyatt to third, Malice to second, and Sines there at first. So Brady comes in and doesn't get an out here in this one. And they'll go back to Carver Pate. He's the fifth pitcher of the ball game for the Bears. So Carver Pate, the redshirt sophomore lefty out of Spokane, Washington, comes in to pitch. Second action of the series for Pate. On the year, Carver, this is his seventh appearance, in 8 and 3rd, he's got a 5.4 ERA, giving up 8 hits, 5 runs, 5 earned runs, 11 walks and 10 strikeouts, opposition in .258 against Pate. Pate in this series came in and pitched an inning in the third in the 12-3 ball game yesterday. Faced 5 batters, got a couple of strikeouts and gave up a base hit, but didn't give up any runs, so pitched effectively yesterday. Going to try to see if he can do it again. Coach Stankiewicz having a team meeting with Greg Bordas over there to his right. Then you got Malice in between number 8 Greg Sines and number 5 Tyler Wyatt. Oops, one run away from getting that 10-run possibility. They got nobody out here in the sixth. 2 runs in the first, 3 runs in the fourth, 4 in the 5th, and now 2 here in the sixth for GCU. They've pounded out 14 hits and 11 runs here. No errors for the Lopes. They left 5 on base. So for the series, as it stands right now, 30 runs for GCU, 38 hits.
Now batting for the Lopes, catcher, Josh Meyer.
You need to put that in perspective, 30 runs on 38 hits for GCU, and for Northern Colorado, you got 5 runs on 15 hits. Meyer at the plate to face Carver Pate. First pitch outside. Ooh, caught the strike zone, I guess. Strike 1. Josh, in this ballgame, 1 for 2, has a run and an RBI. Drove in a run with a single in the 5th and then came around to score. Was hit by a pitch in the 4th. Ground out to 3rd in the 2nd. No outs here. We are in the 6th. That went in there for a strike. So Josh behind the count, no balls and 2 strikes. Mumper on deck. Wyatt at 3rd, Malice at 2nd. Sines over there at 1st base, not being held on. Minnick playing in front of him. Probably looks like they're going to try to come home at the corners and turn 2 up the middle and give away the... Meyer flicked that lead wrist or lead elbow out there. Maybe he could get hit by a pitch, but the way Gary Gilman is, he would not have let him get on base with that one. 1-2 count. We'll take a little time here. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. Nice off-speed pitch. And now the Bears a double play away from getting out of the inning here. So Pate comes in and gets the first man he sees. They bring up Mark Mumper. Mumper a ground out, a sack bunt, and a double. So Mumper 1 for 2 in the series here. Had the 3-run homer yesterday. Mumper now 3-4-9. In there for a strike on the outside corner. So Pate just pacing that outside corner and getting the calls. Fouled off, so Mumper down the count, no balls and 2 strikes. Mumper hitting 176, just trying to get that average back over the Mendoza line. 10 RBI on the year now for Mumper. 9 hits and 10 ribby. The 0-2. Swing and a miss. So Pate comes in and strikes out the first two he faces. Meyer and Mumper go down. And now it'll be up to Austin Bull. Pinch hitter for Austin Bull is going to be number 3, Dane Stankiewicz, the freshman out of Gilbert, Arizona. So Stankiewicz, imagine, will come in and play second base. Stankiewicz looking for his first base hit of his GCU career, 0-5. This is his fifth game. Did get one start. Stankiewicz, a left-handed hitter against the lefty. Now low ball 1. Bull was 0-2 on the day, but had walked a couple of times. Missed down low to Stankiewicz. 2-0. Dan, of course, the son of the skipper, Andy Stankiewicz, down there at third base. Base is still loaded with 2 outs now. Pate's come in and pitched effectively, to say the least. A couple of strikeouts of Meyer and Mumper. 2-0 in their first strike, 2-1. Now Stankiewicz has seen Pate a couple times, ready to go. Fouled off. Count goes to 2-2. Lope scored 2 in the first, 3 in the fourth, 4 in the fifth, and now 2 here in the sixth. The 2-2. Little blooper. Yamaguchi's got it. He'll go to first for the out, and that is the inning. But the Lopes in the inning put 2 on the board. 2 runs, 4 hits, no errors, and 3 left on base as we go to the the 7th inning. 11-2, GCU with the lead. This is Lopes Baseball on GCU TV.
Hello, Phoenix. This is Jerry Colangelo from Grand Canyon University. You can join the GCU community by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors and get the support you need to excel. I look forward to seeing you on campus.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
A.J. Frank's back on the hill for GCU. Came in and pitched a clean 1-2-3 sixth inning and followed Josh Andrews, who came in the fifth, in relief of Jack Schneider. Schneider, the freshman starter, getting his third start of his GCU career. Went 4 1/3, gave up 5 hits, 2 runs. They were both earned. He walked 1 and struck out 2. Andrews came in, pitched 2/3 of an inning, struck out 2 of the 3 batters he faced, walked the other one. And now Frank's in there. Had a clean inning with 1 strikeout. He'll face Keel, Yamaguchi, and Lawson. And so with the fact that Snyder didn't get to go 5, the scoring decision in the hands of Josh Hauser. Who gets the victory if the Lopes can hang on? Ground ball. Hot shot. Took a weird hop over the glove of Malice. Keel takes the turn, but Wyatt over quickly to hold him to a single. Sharply hit, but boy, that ball looked like Malice was there for the backhand. Kicked off the seam, and you can see Zach there at third base kind of kicking the dirt right around the edge of the grass. Base hit single leading off the inning. That's the second time Keel's got a base hit single to lead off the inning. Last time he did it in the fifth, the guy up to the plate right now, Yamaguchi, hit a two-run homer. Yamaguchi one for two. Fly out to center, homer to left. Outside corner strike. Well, definitely a different arm angle here. Yeah, the one caveat, if the Lopes can 10-run this game and get it in under nine, are you allowed then to give the win to Jack Schneider? Swing and a miss. You are? Well, had Coach Tankiewicz known that and cared, maybe he squeezed bunts with the bases loaded up nine. Probably not what you want to do to endear yourself to the rest of the conference. 0-2 count to Yamaguchi. Lopes lead 11-2. Little chopper. Malice going to get the lead runner at second. Back to first, not in time. Nicely done by Malice, cutting off Mumper. Get the lead man. So Yamaguchi at first with the fielder's choice. Keel retired 5-4 for the first out of the inning. Let me bring up Dean Lawson. Lawson 0-3 in the ballgame. A strikeout, a pop-out, and a fly-out to right. Lawson 1-10 as the leadoff man here in this series. And there for a strike on the outside corner. Yeah, squeeze bunting to get to 10 runs when you're already up nine. Kind of like fouling guys so Devin Booker can get over 70. Whoa, did I say that out loud? Throw over and the runner back. The 0-1. Oh, chopper. Franks has it. Looks at second. Fires to first. Calmly done. Yamaguchi down to second. Lawson retired for the fourth time in the ballgame. Now 1-11 as the leadoff man. Smart play there by Franks. Yeah, he could have tried to get the lead man, but, boy, he just feels it. Gives that little glance. Realizes it might have had him, but would have had to take a perfect throw, and why risk it when you're up by 9, 11-2 here in the seventh. Evan Johnson at the plate. Johnson 0-3. Little squibber over Stankiewicz's head into right field. They're going to try to score the run. The throw going to be in time. Yamaguchi jumps up to try to go around. And now Franks looking. I think they're going to kick him out of the game. Yeah, they just ran Yamaguchi out of the game for that slide. And, boy, that's probably actually pretty smart. I don't know what Iwasaki's arguing about. He jumped up in the air. Josh, who's got a bit of a hair trigger temper, and Yamaguchi throws the helmet off and shows the hairdo as he walks off. But Yamaguchi is out of the ball game and kind of jumped into Josh Meyer. Meyer tagged him, and you could see A.J. Franks kind of staring him down afterwards. Did not endear himself to the Lopes or to the umpiring crew, and we'll have to see if anything comes of this, but a great throw. You see the replay here, a great throw by Garrison Schwartz. Meyer making the tag, and then the jump, which that is just a weird way to go if you're Yamaguchi, not sure what he was trying to do. And Meyer kind of stared at him, looked at him a bit. Meyer gives him a little shove there for the contact. And you can see the home plate umpire, Gary Gilman, yelling, no, 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 right there. And he immediately goes right after Yamaguchi and says, nope, not doing that here. Little smile on the face of Meyer. He didn't sure what exactly was going on, but you can see A.J. Franks. He was back and up to play. He walked over to home plate, and it was A.J. that was more mad than anybody, standing up for his catcher there. He was standing right by the plate, kind of staring down Yamaguchi. We're in the bottom of the seventh, stretch time here, 11-2 GCU. Well, folks, check out companies on campus next week in the Student Union. Network with different companies, learn about jobs and internships, and maybe even land a job. More info, contact career services at gcu.edu. Follow them on Facebook for future opportunities at facebook.com/gcucareerservices. Well, very exciting end to the top of the seventh, and now the umps are going to go over and have a chat. Steve Mattingly, the crew chief, I believe, chatting with the head coach, Carl Iwasaki, and he's kicked out of the ballgame. And Iwasaki gives him the nod and says, yep, he's out of the ballgame. Gary Gilman, the home plate umpire, very quickly said he was out. And now it looks like Yamaguchi not out of the ballgame. So Stankiewicz, so Yamaguchi grabs his hat, heads out to short. So I guess they kicked him out and then reversed the call. Coach Stankiewicz asking about that one. And now Andy having a chat. You see the replay again here. Yamaguchi, as he jumps into Meyer, didn't try to spike him or anything. I mean, it was more of a weird play than a dangerous play, I think. Kind of leapt into him. Meyer makes the tag, but so Yamaguchi initially ejected from the ball game, but then reinstated in the ball game. I guess it was a late April Fool's joke by the home plate umpire Gary Gilman. LaRouge, Evan Schwartz. Pitch high and tight from Pate. Lopes lead at 11-2. They could walk it off here if they score a couple of runs, and then that would also give Schneider his second victory. In the air to right field. That'll get down. LaRouche thinking two. Going to go two as he gets under the glove. He was on his horse. Didn't break stride in the second. The leadoff double for LaRouche. And Tom, the game-winning run out there at second. So Schneider could go to 2-0. A couple of conference wins if the Lopes can end it here. Tom just staying with it and rips it into right. Evans at the plate. Tom LaRouche now 2-for-4 out there at second. First pitch to Evans up high, ball one. Yeah, well, we see things for the first time a lot here in conference play, and never seen a guy try to get around to tag that way, leaping in the air, and never seen a guy ejected and reinstated, all within about a 45 to 60 second span. The 1-0. And there for a strike, 1-1. Ian Evans having a day, 3-for-4. He had struggled, had 4 RBI coming into this ball game, but you know, in the series until today was just 1-for-7. He's 3-for-4 now, so 4-for-11 in the series. The 1-1. Breaking pitch down low. 2-1. Evans a single to drive in a run in the first, a double in the third, a ground out in the fourth, and a double and then scored a run in the sixth. Check of the runner, Pate with the delivery. In the air, shallow. Tanner coming over, make the grab. LaRouche cannot tag, so out number one, a fly out to center. That'll bring up Garrison Schwartz. Schwartz had a sack fly to center in the first, ground out to second in the third, a ground out to first in the fifth, and a double, an RBI double. And scored a run in the sixth. Base hit here would end the ball game. They got the shift on. In there for strike one. Yamaguchi, the shortstop, playing very near the bag, trying to keep LaRouche close to the bag. Bumgarner dealing his no hit. The Diamondbacks threw four. Fly ball to left. Johnson. Camping makes the grab. Two outs. So Wyatt at the plate. Wyatt ground into a double play in the first, but in the fourth, fifth, and sixth, a single, a walk, and a single, scored a couple of runs. So Wyatt, 2-for-3 with 2 runs scored. Fastball missed inside, ball one. Congrats goes out to the women's tennis team. Beat UMKC to win the regular season WAC championship. Nicely done for women's tennis. The 0-1. Two and zero the count. Congrats to Coach Greg Perdome and his squad. Regular season WAC championship for women's tennis. Two account to Wyatt, trying to deliver a base hit here. Bring in LaRouge. In there for a strike, 2-1 now. Action out in the pen for GCU. The 2-1. 3-1. So the action out there in the bullpen, just in case this game goes another inning or so. Zach McLeod, the 6-1 sophomore lefty out of Greenway High in Phoenix. A 3-1 pitch should get a good one to hit. In the air, left center field, that's the ball game. Tyler Wyatt get credited with a base hit single. And LaRouge comes in to score, and that should be the game. 12-2 GCU as Wyatt delivers the two-out base knock to get the victory for the Lopes. Well, Wyatt had a fantastic game there, and that enables the starter to get the victory for GCU. Jack Schneider will get the win. The Lopes sweep this series, go to 12-14 overall, a perfect 6-0 on the year in the WAC. Northern Colorado 11-15, 3-3 in Western Athletic Conference play. New Mexico State still on top of Seattle 5-2. And if that holds, the Lopes and New Mexico State are the only two undefeated teams in conference play. Vaqueros up 4-2 on Bakersfield. Well, as the teams shake hand here, final is going to be 12-2 in 7. Jack Schneider gets the win. He gets the win for his second win of the season. And goes to 2-0 on the year. 4 1/3, 5 hits, 2 runs. They were both earned. He walked one and struck out two, but his team picked him up as they end this one in 7. Well, that'll do it for us here. Thanks so much for joining us on the WAC Digital Network for the first game in GCU TV. Lopes hit the road, 8 of their next 9 on the road. The one that come back here on Tuesday, April 11th, for a great game against number 15 U of A. Catch that game on CW6 and ESPN. And as always, right here on GCU TV. That's Tuesday, April 11th. Don't forget, I'll be talking to the head coach and one of the players after the ball game. We'll have that in the wrap-up story at GCULopes.com as well as on SoundCloud. You can follow us on Twitter at GCU Baseball and at GCU_Lopes to see it as well. Thanks so much to Elliot, Taylor, Krista, Aaron and Gina. I'm Michael. Thanks for joining us. Follow Grand Canyon University on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/GCU. Have a great night. Go Lopes.